Is Gabe Landeskog the best captain in the playoffs? I think Game 1 is a great case for the answer to that being yes. Avs win over the St. Louis Blues 4-1.
Oh my goodness gracious! Wasn't it time? Score! Justice is served!
Look, I'm not going to go crazy here. Obviously, Gabe isn't the best hockey-playing captain. That goes to Connor McDavid. The talent is just too ridiculous there. But when you look at the picture as a whole, Landy, he has the offensive ability. He has the defensive ability. He is a great trash talker. He's willing to stand up for his teammates. He's always played with a bit of an edge to his game, and as he starts to get older and wiser, he hasn't crossed that line in a while. I think he might actually be the best captain in the NHL if you look at the complete package. And he showed that off early in this hockey game. Mikko takes a bit of a knee-on-knee hit. Looking at it in the end, I thought it was a clean hit, but obviously players on the ice, that's hard to tell. Landy goes right to bat and decides to fight Braden Schenn to stand up for Mikko.
Kind of a crazy fight, as Schenn actually had to shed this ref for it to even happen. There's a different angle that I don't have that shows it in full, where he had to go all the way around the ref to get into Landy here, so that's kind of why they had to skate halfway across the ice to get this fight going. They get into it, and Landy just starts absolutely throwing bombs there. He does take one shot, a little jab to the face from Schenn here that probably breaks his nose, as you'll see when they come back around. Landy, very red nose there. It's not bloodied, but he definitely took a shot. It looks a little off kilter, but worth it. Landy absolutely wins the fight, and then this is the greatest scene in hockey right here. Schenn goes down, gives a little bit of the head turtle, and Landy, being the absolute gentleman of a captain that he is, he's got the arm raised, he could pummel him, but he chooses not to. He does not throw the punch to a downed opponent. Looking at you, Tom Wilson. That is what the best captains in the league do. There aren't many captains out there that are willing to fight and are decent fighters like Landy while also being quality hockey players. Whatever he and the Avs are doing, it must be clean living because we only had one post in this game and it was a good one. Good post number one of the playoffs. So far, so good in that category for the Avs. This was a whale of a hockey game for the Avs. The final score was 4-1, and that doesn't accurately represent the domination provided by Colorado. They outshot St. Louis 50-23 in the end. 50 shots on goal. That's not a number you hear very often, certainly not in the playoffs, and the Avs got there. Credit to Jordan Binnington. He played extremely well. If not for him, the Blues very likely get blown out of this game quite quickly, as shots were 18-5 in the first period alone. The Avs just couldn't quite seem to solve him at 5-on-5, but eventually they get themselves on the power play, and yeah, they have the special teams. This team can do the special teams battle. If they can win it, nobody's going to beat them. I think it's that simple. Minute left on the power play. The Avs win the faceoff back to Cale Makar, and Cale Makar just might not actually be human. The way he twists and contorts his body while he's skating, walking the blue line, it's just, it fools people. It confuses the hell out of a forward trying to defend him. Just walks a dude into the ether there. That man is gone. He doesn't exist anymore. He might as well be the invisible man, because Makar now has all the space in the world to walk into by a simple little duck, dive, dip, shimmy move, whatever you want to call it. He takes advantage, gets to the open spot, waits for Mikko to get the screen in front. You have a little bit of a screen from Donskoy in the high slot as well, and rips it right into the net. Have I mentioned that Cale Makar is incredibly fun to watch? First goal of the playoffs for the Avs goes to him. The Avs take the 1-0 lead into intermission. Probably should have been 2-0. Mikko missed a wide open tap-in at the end of the period. Thankfully, since we know the final score, it didn't come back to bite the Avs. The second period was probably the most even period of the game, unusual for the Avs. That's usually their dominant one. Still think they were the better team in the period.
despite them not being able to score. Again, Jordan Binnington really came online in the second period. It was pretty clear that Mikko Rantanen was pretty snakebit, as Binnington just seemed to have his number no matter what he did, and the Avs couldn't quite solve the problem. That left the door open. Not going to make any bones about it. St. Louis probably had no business being in this game, and instead, near the end of the second period, they tie it up. The Avs have the puck in the offensive zone right about here. Kadri tries to walk a guy walking into the zone, and it just doesn't work. He just gets his pocket picked clean. It's a break back the other way. Kadri trying to get back to be part of the denial. There is a tangle up here. I think that's pretty clear. How much of a stick hold is happening right here? How much is Kadri throwing his stick out to try and impede a blue? A little bit of both. Could there have been a call here? Yeah, maybe. But I'm not 100% solid. I think it could have gone either way. The call ultimately doesn't get made, as Kadri looks like he got grabbed a little bit, but also looks like he tries to sell the hell out of this call. And as he doesn't get the call, he's now behind the play, can't get all the way back in and defend Kyrou effectively. The Blues work it over pretty simply here. Tough spot for Timmins as he gets beat by the sauce pass, and Kyrou just finishes nicely. Look, every hockey team has been in this situation before, and there's that little thought in the back of your head, that worry that when you play that good of a 40 minutes and you don't have the lead, you might be in trouble, because it's hard to play complete domination hockey for a full 60 minutes, and the other team is going to have all of the jump, all of the energy. They've gotten themselves back into the game and could easily come back and win. It's a worry. It's a concern. In the end, though, the Avs waste no time. They put the hammer down immediately in the third period, and they beat Jordan Binnington. Once that goal went in, this game was over. If the fight didn't sell you on Landy being the best captain in the playoffs, how about this play? The Avs win a puck battle deep in their own corner here. Makar is going to be able to get this up to Landy, who's hanging out in the circle, and Landy makes a risky but beautiful and effective backhand pass across to Mikko through his own slot. Mikko's able to get the puck up the ice, gets held up at the blue line. Is it interference? It's the NHL. I'm not going to get into that conversation. Landy, hustling through, is the man to get to the puck and keep this play alive while he just works in the corner. Will not be taken off this puck. Refuses to get beat by the Blues and eventually throws it down to Mikko, who now has space in behind the net. Oh, right, that's Nathan MacKinnon coming down the slot. Why did we defend Landeskog with three players? Oh, no, the puck is in the net. Avs take the 2-1 lead and don't look back, and Landy was just getting warmed up. Obviously never comfortable with a one-goal lead, so about 8 minutes later, Landy takes care of that. Some fun work from Devon Taves here, who goes coast to coast. It's not completely clean, as he does gain the blue line and kind of fires it in, but he has the speed to go and get his own puck here in deep, is able to throw it in. Again, not clean, but it functioned. Gets it to Mikko down deep in the corner, with Taves in deep, Nathan MacKinnon sitting out up high covering back, as Mikko gets this up to Girard, who feeds it across to Mac. Mac fires this one towards the net. Who's that? Staying on his feet after getting cross-checked in front, Gabe Landeskog puts the tip on it. And if that ain't just the prettiest tip you ever did see, I mean, you can't draw it up better than that. The captain completes the Gordie Howe hat trick in game one of the playoffs. He can score. He can defend. He can be physical. He'll stand up for his teammates. The guy is just the complete package, and even with a broken nose, might be the sexiest hockey player ever to live. Man Rocket is in the building. The Avs, for the most part, would cruise at home. The Blues would like to get a little bit chippy at times, but that doesn't get you back in the hockey game, does it? Eventually, MacKinnon gets the empty netter with an assist from, you guessed it, Gabe Landeskog, and the Avs skate away to a 4-1 final. I'm going to be honest. I don't think the Blues have a whole lot of hope in this series after that game. Jordan Binnington had a 939 save percentage, and the Blues found a way to play bad enough in front of him that they lost anyway. Sure, the Blues are down a couple of players. That sucks, but that's life. Anything can happen, of course. There's a reason they play the games, but right now, if I'm the Avalanche, I am feeling extremely confident and just wanting to go out there and repeat this process. They will win games by significantly more than 3 goals if they play like that with any amount of consistency. That is the end of this game video review. Thank you for watching. Head on over to the DNVR for more playoff coverage top to bottom. We got everything you could want over there. I am Rudo, and let the beard growing begin.
Avalanche time, come on, grab your friends. We're